It is a privilege to stand before you and give you a report on how the work is progressing in Zambia, Malawi, and now we have a third country, that's Mozambique. We began working with the help of Steps to Life. They have been very instrumental in helping us as we try to coordinate the work in these countries. I became acquainted with Malawi when I received correspondence from Steps to Life, and I was requested to meet a certain brother who had written to Steps to Life and was interested in receiving spiritual help. So I made the first trip there. It should have been in the year 2011. And when we met, we discussed progress, and we had the first crusade that was organized there. I conducted it, and after the crusade, we baptized 28 people, and the first church was established there. And I'm happy to report to you that that church is still there up to today. So we sincerely, from the bottom of our hearts, on behalf of Zambia Malawi Division of Recent Adventists, we thank Steps to Life for the work that they are doing in helping us, those of us that are in Africa. We have received massive spiritual help, and we have made progress due to the commitment that they have shown. The formation of the division, that's Zambia Malawi Division of Recent Adventists, was as a result of the challenges that we were facing. One of the biggest problems that we face as independent Adventists is that we tend to speak against organization, and this has been a big problem. It has deterred the work. So we realized that for as long as we were not organized, it was going to be a big problem. So with the help of Steps to Life, as well as the input that Pastor Nunes had put in, we were able to come together and come up with the Zambia Malawi Division of Free Seventh Adventists. And like I've already stated, Mozambique has now jumped in, and there's three countries as we speak. There's a few challenges that are being faced, especially in Mozambique. The area there where Pastor Campini is now operating from, initially he was working from Malawi, but because of the message of country living, he decided to move to the countryside. Malawi is a very small country, and it has a huge population compared to Zambia. So the land there is, people jostle for the land. So the only land that he could get was in Mozambique. So he moved to Mozambique, that is just across the border with Malawi. So the area where he's operating from was involved in a civil war. The civil war lasted for about 21 years. And most of those people there were displaced. So now they are coming back, and they are setting up a shelter that is not necessarily up to the standard, but something that they can use. One of the reasons is that the memories of the bloody war is still fresh, and they fear that the war might recur. And as a result of this, the area has been neglected. It has not been developed by the government of Mozambique. So this area is around a mountain known as Zalamanyama Forest. Behind the mountain, there's a forest reserve. So the mountain stretches for about 150 kilometers, and it is known by different names in the three different countries, that's Zambia, Malawi, and Mozambique. Around this area, the challenges that are there is that we do not have schools, hospitals, and the roads, as well as communication network, is not very good. As a result of this, Pastor Campini and the church there thought it imperative to see what they could do about this, and they have decided to come up with a school. This school is, as at now, operating on a big rock. So they are using the same rock as a school, as well as a place to meet and worship. The work is very massive because the natives here, like I've already stated, most of them cannot read, they cannot write because there are no schools. And this is because of the situation that took place, the bloody war. So Pastor Campini felt it incumbent upon himself and the church that they set up a school and they start helping people to know how to read and write. And other than that, the beliefs of most of these people, they believe in the worship of ancestors, and they can worship anything, literally. They can worship trees, they can worship a chicken, and I'm not trying to be sensational here. These are people that are involved in spiritualism, so the work there is quite vast. Efforts have been put in place, and a lot of progress has been made. And since he moved there, a church has been established consisting of 36 members. And between this church and another church that has been established, there's a distance of about 15 kilometers. Another church of 14 members also has been established. And the establishing of this school is a means to reach out to souls. Because they cannot read, it is hoped that once they enroll, one of the programs that we hope to be offering is the training program for ministers and church leaders, which Steps to Life has graciously offered to us. And we hope to be using Unit 1 of the training program to help these people to get to know about Jesus Christ and the work that he's doing in the sanctuary above. Other subjects that we're looking at are subjects like Portuguese, English, mathematics, and then life skills. It is not an easy undertaking, but by God's grace, we hope that we will succeed. In August, we hope to go and launch medical missionary work, that is my wife and I, in Mozambique, so that the people could also start, so that they could be trained in medical missionary work. Just before I came here, that is a week before I came here, we had a youth Bible conference in Malawi, and after the conference, we, by God's grace, managed to baptize 22 souls. And close to where the Bible conference was being conducted was a Sunday-keeping church known as Zion Sunday Church. So they heard about what we were doing there, and some of their members came through, and they learned about the Sabbath. We had a series of meetings with them, and 36 of those people decided to detach themselves from that Sunday-keeping church, and a church has been established there. They are worshiping on their own. And we, among some of the things that we discussed with them, is that there's need for us to provide training for them, that is the leaders, using the training program for ministers and church leaders. We have a challenge, that is they'll need Spirit of Prophecy books as well as Bibles. The other progress that has been made is the printing press that has been acquired with the help of Steps to Life. We again thank Steps to Life for graciously providing means for us to get the press. It is hoped that with the press that has been established, we can print literature and books that can then go out and help us proclaim the everlasting gospel. We are training Bible workers, and we hope that some of these young men could be engaged in this work by selling some of these materials that we are printing, and then the revenue that is generated could be used to take care of them as they are moving about proclaiming the everlasting gospel. The training is making progress so far. For Zambia, we have 6 people that have completed 6 units out of the 7 units of the training program for ministers and church leaders. And 21 are making progress in their training. In Malawi, we have 12 that are on the program. One of the reasons why we have not made that much progress in this area in Malawi has been because of the language barrier. Most people there cannot read and write English. But by the grace of God, the program has, we have started translating it into the local language, that is the Chichewa language. And the first unit of the training program has been translated. And we are trying to move to the second unit. So the first unit has been translated, and we believe since the first unit has been translated, it's going to be made available to as many people as possible. So the people that are going to be benefited from the translation are the people that are living not just in Malawi, but eastern part of Zambia, as well as some parts of Mozambique. So this will enable us to reach out to many of these people. Other than that, one of the challenges that we have faced as we have endeavored to spearhead the gospel is the materials have been a challenge. Also regarding the training, it's been a bit of a challenge, but with the coming in of the press, we are very, very confident that it will be much, much easier for us to reach out to many souls as well as to train as many workers as we possibly can. We have been benefited a lot through this training that has been provided for us. We are looking at it as a basis for uniting the churches in Zambia, Malawi, as well as now Mozambique. Hebrews 13 verse 1 tells us, let brotherly love continue. And what we have witnessed as a result of this training is that it has helped us to be in tune with one another. The language that we are speaking is the same. And the unity that we are experiencing is second to none. The medical missionary work, we realize, is the right hand of the third angel's message. And we want to also step up efforts in ensuring that we can train as many workers as possible. We have seen a lot of progress that has been achieved as a result of us engaging in this work. The youths in Zambia have been on fire. They've been going out there, doing what they can do with the resources that they have, reaching out to souls through medical missionary work, as well as a massive literature distribution. So God has really been with us, and we have seen that his hand is upon us. And we request that the people here continue praying for us and encouraging us. And by his grace, we believe a lot more is going to be done. The other work also, this is why again, I'm taking advantage of this opportunity to encourage Steps to Life. Also, other ministries that they are working with, Pastor Ivan Plummer and others. The work that you are doing, God will bless you. And please do not be discouraged when you face some challenges. The impact that it is having on us is just indescribable. We, most of the contacts that we have had, it's because of the communication that is there between Steps to Life as well as other people. The work that is being done on the internet as well as maybe TV, radio. Some of the people that are watching through internet and radio, they communicate to Steps to Life, and sometimes we receive correspondence and we make those follow-ups. I was 2 years ago, given a contact from one of the cities in Zambia by Steps to Life. I made a follow-up. We had a meeting with that man. He is a bishop with one of the Pentecostal churches. So it turned out that he wanted us to visit Congo. He told me there were 36 churches there that were interested in working with Steps to Life. So I made that trip, and the first day, they gave me an opportunity to speak to 40 of their bishops with their wives. And I spoke to them, and after that, they gave me an opportunity to speak in 6 of their churches. And we made progress. They requested that we conduct training for their leaders as well as for the congregation. But since that time, we haven't had an opportunity to go there. But these people have not relented. They keep on knocking on our doors. I remember even just today I was sharing with Pastor Nunes. I was showing him the WhatsApp message that I received from one of the bishops. He is saying, "We are waiting for you." And the number of these churches has since increased from the initial 36 to 50. And if you would have to do a rough estimate of how many people that might be, maybe we're talking about just if we have to be realistic, not less than 5,000 people. So the Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 24, verse 14, that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to all the world as a witness. And then if we have this privilege of speaking to 5,000 people, why not seize this opportunity to help hasten the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ? Yeah, so they are waiting for us, and we hope by God's grace that we are going to make a trip there and see how we can help these people have the opportunity to hear the three angels' messages. Yeah, so again, thank you to Steps to Life and other ministries. You have no idea how the people back home regard you and the work that you are doing there. And the commitment, the sacrifice that every one of you has been putting in, we hope that God will bless you. Before, there was a gentleman some years back by the name of Mark Woodman. He was a South African. He developed cancer. He had preached. He was an Adventist just for about 5 years. And within that 5 years, he had done a lot of work. And one of the things that he said in the last message that he had recorded a few days before he died, a message that they actually played on his funeral, among some of the ministries that he actually appealed to not to give up, was Steps to Life. He said, please do not give up. The work that you've been doing has been great. And whatever you do, the pressure that you may receive, please keep on fighting. Continue giving people life jackets. This world is a sinking Titanic. Yeah. And continue proclaiming the everlasting gospel. So I take advantage of this opportunity to encourage Steps to Life and all those people that are supporting Steps to Life to continue doing so. Because the work that is being achieved is just marvelous. And we believe that God has placed a huge responsibility upon you, and that you have been ordained to coordinate the work worldwide. And you need to understand that you must not give up, regardless of the challenges that you seem to be encountering. God works in mysterious ways. Just a short testimony. I hope I'll manage to finish it. There's a crusade that I was conducting in Malawi, and we noticed that every time very few people would come, and we were wondering what was going on. Sometimes maybe just 3 would come, and we continued preaching until the last day for 21 days. After 21 days, the last Sabbath of the meeting, We were surprised where the people came from. The entire place was just filled up with people. And when we asked where those people had come from, how come they knew about the meeting, they said, we were listening from our homes every day. Yeah. So God can do great things. He can do wonders for us if we remain committed to this work. And again, my appeal is let's continue working. Challenges will definitely be there, but let's not give up hope. Soon, Jesus will come, and he's going to reward us for the efforts and the commitments that we have been making for him. Yeah. So I shudder and I fear when I think about the possibility of people like Pastor Plummer, Pastor John, Pastor Nunes, them putting, when they put the banner down, the consequences for the work can be very dire. So against this background, I urge every one of us to be on our knees to continue praying for these people. And please, don't give up. However rough the road gets, do not give up. Continue working, continue being committed, and when Jesus comes, we'll be rewarded. May God bless every one of us. Amen. Amen.